We have 2008, paper 2, number 1. 2008, paper 2, question 1. This one, they say that the probability that Anne reads the vision is 0.75. In this case, what I can do, begin by defining the events to reduce. You could say, let capital N represent new vision. In this question, we have the new vision and we have the daily monitor. So you would say, let N represent new vision and let D represent daily monitor. They say that the probability that Anne read new vision is 0.75, meaning probability of new vision is 0.75. Then they say that the probability that she reads neither new vision nor daily monitor is 0.65. The probability that she reads new vision and not daily monitor, it is 0.65. Then they say that the probability that she reads neither of the papers is 0.15. The probability that she reads neither is 0.15. Then they say, find the probability that she reads daily monitor. Find the probability of her reading daily monitor. Now, in this question, what you will do, you will begin by simplifying this expression here. So based on what Morgan showed, we saw earlier on that the probability of N complement, section B complement, this becomes 1 minus probability of N union D. Of course, this one is known as 0.15 is equal to 1 minus probability of N union D. This comes this side, giving us probability of N union D as 1 minus 0.15. This simplifies to 0.85. Likewise, you would come and simplify this given expression. Of course, from this one, using set theory, the probability of N, section D complement, this becomes probability of N minus probability of N, section D. This one is given as 0.65. The P of N, we know it as 0.75 minus P of N, section D. This comes this side, this comes the other way, giving us probability of N, section D, as 0.75 minus 0.65. This becomes 0.1. So likewise, now using additive rule, which says probability of N union D, this becomes probability of N plus probability of D minus probability of N, section D. Now for this one, we know it as 0.85. For this one, we don't know it. PP of N, we still know it as 0.75. Plus probability of the monitor, which is anonymous, we don't know it. And then likewise, minus for intersection, know it as 0.1. So when simplifying, I'll have 0.85 is equal to 0.6 minus 0.1 becomes 0.65 plus probability of daily monitor. This comes this way, giving us P of D as 0.2. Here they say find the probability that she reads daily monitor, giving us answers 0.2. 2014, paper 2, question number 9, part B. It says that events A and B assert that the probability of A is equal to 4 divided by 7, comma, probability of A, section B, complement, is given by 1 divided by 3. And then the probability of A given B, it is 5 divided by 14. Then they say that find Roman number 1, the probability of B, and Roman 2, the probability of A complement section B complements. Now for this one, you would begin by simplifying this expression. So I'll say the probability of A given B. This becomes probability of A section B divided by the probability of B. If I put over 1 here and I cross multiply, it simply means that the probability of A section B, this will give me probability of A given B times probability of B. But they had said find probability of B, meaning in this case the probability of B shall give me the probability of A section B divided by probability of A given B. This one is already known as 5 over 14, meaning I'll find this using this very expression. Therefore, I'll say the probability of A section B complement, this becomes probability of A minus probability of A section B. Now, this one we know it as 1 divided by 3. This one we know it as 4 divided by 7 minus probability of A section B. Meaning, probability of A section B, this would give us 4 divided by 7 minus 1 divided by 3, giving us probability of A section B as this is going to be 12 minus 7 divided by 21. This one shall give us now a 5 divided by 21. So I'll say that from this one, the probability of B shall thus give us A section B, it is this 5 divided by 21 divided by A given B, it is 5 divided by 14. This will become 5 over 21 and with 14 divided by 5. This will cancel by 7, I'll get 2, by 7, I'll get 3. And therefore, I'll say the probability of B shall thus give me 2 divided by 3. And then they say find this. Now for this one, you apply the Ronald rule by saying the probability of A given B complement, this becomes 1 minus probability of A union B. Now from this, I can find B of A union B by saying this becomes probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A section B, of which probability of A we know it as 4 divided by 7 plus probability of B, which is now given to us as 2 divided by 3 minus P of A section B, which becomes 5 divided by 21. This one will give us a 1. But let's say 5 probability of A complement section B complement. This becomes 1 minus 1, which will give us a 0. 2013, paper 2, number 4. They say that events A and B are such that the probability of A, section B, is 1 out of 12. And then the probability and the probability of A given B, it is 1 divided by 3. And then then they say find the probability of B, the section A complements. This is required. Now what you will do in this case, you first expand this. Now this one, expanding it, will give us the probability of A given B. This becomes probability of A section B over probability of B. This one, we know it as this. This we still know it, meaning you find probability of B. Thus, probability of B becomes probability of A intersection B divided by probability of A given B. Thus, I would say this one will give us P of B, as this one it is 1 out of 12 divided by this, it is a third, giving us 1 out of 12 and with 3 divided by a 1. This will give us 1 divided by 4. Then they say find this one. From set theory, the probability of B intersection A complement, this becomes probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. That's on substituting, the P of B is a quarter minus A intersection B, it is 1 divided by 12. Thus, I would say LSTM is 12, so I would say this becomes 3 minus a 1. Thus, I would say this becomes 2 divided by a 12, which is 1 over 6. 2002, part 2, question number 1. Here they say that on a given day, fresh fish from Lakes Choga, Victoria, Albert, George were supplied to a given market in Kampala. In this case, what you will do, begin by defining the events. You would say let K represent Choga. Then likewise, let V represent Victoria. Then you would say let A represent Albert. Then let G represent George. Then we say that fresh fish is applied from the lakes above there. Then they say that in the ratios of 30%, 40%, 20%, and 10%, meaning the probability of the fish supplied from Lake Choga, it is 30%, which is 0.3. The probability of getting fish in the market from Lake Victoria, it is 40%, which is 0.4. The probability of getting fish from Lake Albert, it is 0.20%, which is 0.2. And likewise, getting fish from Lake George, it's given as 10%, which is 0.1. Then they say that each lake had a given ratio of poisoned fish, in a ratio of 3%, 3%, and 1% respectively. So in this case, we have the fish from all these lakes. But the fish being brought in these lakes are poisoned. Some of them are poisoned. Therefore, the probability, we say, let P represent poison fish. Therefore, the probability of getting poison fish, given it's from Lake Choga, it's given to us here as 2%, which becomes 2 over 100, which becomes 0.02. Then likewise, the probability of getting poisoned fish, given it's from Lake Victoria, it's given to us as 0.03. And likewise, the probability of getting poisoned fish, given it's from Lake Albert, it is still 3%, which is 0.03. And lastly, getting poisoned fish, given it's from Lake George, it is 1%, which is 0.01. Then they said that if the health inspector picked a fish at random, but they say it's find the probability that the fish was poisoned. Now this one can be done in two different ways. In this case, case number one, I can draw a sketch, represent this. We have this and we have that. We are having, this is our central market, having fish from various sources or lakes. In this case, we have the Choga, Victoria, Abraham, then George. I could say, we are having this as Choga, we are having this, and we are having that. Choga, and we are having this. This is Victoria, This is Albert, then this is George. Of course, each leg had a given amount of poisoned fish. But in place of choga, some part is poisoned and some part here is also poisoned, all throughout. It implies this one here is the probability of poisoned fish, a section choga. This becomes probability of P, a section George. This becomes P of poison, a section Albert. Lastly, this becomes P of poison, a section Victoria. Now, in this case, it implies that the probability of getting poisoned fish shall become these ones here added together, giving us probability of P, a section K, plus P of P, a section V, plus P of V, P, a section Albert, plus P of P, a section George. Now, of course, this one here, from this one can be simplified. This one is simplified as probability of P given K, hence P of K. Plus, this becomes still probability of P given V, hence P of V. This becomes probability of P given A, hence P of A. And lastly, this becomes probability of P given G, hence P of G. And thus, on simplifying, I'll have this one, we know it as 0.02 times this one, it is 0.3. Plus this one, it is 0.03 times this one, it is 0.4. Plus this one, it is 0.03 times Albert, it is 0.2. Plus lastly, George is 0.01 times 0.1. This one will simplify to get our answer. This becomes probability of getting poisoned fish. This becomes 0.025. There is part of the question, but they say it's given that the fish was poisoned. They say given that the fish was poisoned. Given the fish was poisoned. Then they say that what's the probability that was found to make Albert? Meaning here, put here. Albert, given the fish was poisoned, then we say find the probability that from like Albert here like this. This one will simplify becomes P of A, a section P divided by probability of P. Now this one is same as this expression, is same as this one. And this one yields this. So I'll say this becomes 0.03 times 0.2 divided by this P of P 0.25, and therefore our final answer will give us, this will give us 0.03 times 0.2 over 0.025. So simplifying, I'll have 0.2.